microfluidics has been evolving very rapidly. It, you know, started out as a sort of tool for analytical chemistry, and then with the development of microfluidic large-scale automation, it enabled access to many more challenges and problems in biology.
I think the field of microfluidics in some ways have matured. So for example, in the field of genomics, you now have microfluidics in many sequencing machines. And the users very often doesn't even know, which is a good thing.
Technology is maturing, and people are less focused on technology development, more focused on how to use it to do science.
It's only now that we're actually beginning to see serious consideration of what's required for microfluidics to be actually part of a product, if not a product in itself.
The major technological breakthrough in the field of microfluidics, in my mind, I guess I would say, is the popularization of soft lithography by George Whitesides.
One of the major challenges for the future of microfluidics is integration. And I think the problem is that we every year see new tools, but these tools are not all compatible with each other, so it's a big challenge to build something bigger out of small parts.
But one of the biggest challenges in microfluidics right now is how to keep on the sort of exponential scaling curve of more experiments per chip and less cost per experiment.
What we will see is that the diagnostics field will profit a lot from microfluidics. So many assays that are at the moment carried out in centralized labs will be done at point of care.
In point of care diagnostics, I think the paper microfluidics has a very good potential because there we can really develop systems that can be used in the field.
If we can play a role in our own monitoring of our own health, and that can be analysed, whether it's directly connected via your phone to the internet or to the internet, then I think we can actually prevent an awful lot of disease.
The goal is always to ensure that as many people as possible can use the developments that we and others create.
Well, initially I wasn't very enthusiastic about adding yet another microfluidic conference to the world, and so we decided that we'd change the focus. So we decided we'd organize a meeting that was focused on how people use microfluidics in biology and problems of basic science.
This conference is different to a variety, many other conferences actually, because I think there's a specific focus on the serious side of the biology.
Well, this is very highly focused on the current state of the art of microfluidics, particularly as it's applied to biology. We'll be right back.